Business owner Aaron Kennedy. He wasn't always rich. He grew up in Illinois. He wasn't connected to any kind of big money. I mean, all he had was drive. When he was 8 years old, Kennedy sold greeting cards in the fall. And then in the spring, he'd get back on his bike and go door to door selling vegetable seed packets. He eventually had enough money to go to graduate school in Madison, Wisconsin. There's your first mistake. Several years later, he was working in New York City, and he was eating noodles from an Asian restaurant, and I can bet you which one it was, because I've eaten there. And it gave him a big idea. He shared it with his wife, and he scribbled the idea down on a napkin, and the idea for Noodles and Company was born. It wasn't easy to do this company. He had to scramble. He had to convince 24 friends and family members to invest in his idea. Imagine putting your name down on your friends and say, no, trust me on this. It's going to be a good risk. He took the risk, and so did his friends and family. If he didn't make it, he would have to lay people off, close them down, go bankrupt, and then he'd have to face his family and friends who had trusted him with their money. That's part of the American dream. Everyone has a chance. Well, one of his employees didn't see things quite the same way. He's successful now. But during the protests in Wisconsin, one of his employees showed up. He's a member of the International Socialist Organization, the ISO. Remember I told you about this yesterday? These are the people that got the permits for the Union Van Jones rally in Washington, D.C. I want to show you the protesters. This is last Saturday. These are the protesters last Saturday. Now, show the pictures of in front of the Wisconsin Capitol building today. Do you see this? You see the signs? I asked them to get one and blow it up for me. This is the International Socialist Union. Union members, this is, if you look right here, can you show this? Can you show this here? This is the, right here, the AFL-CIO. You tell me. Is it a coincidence? Okay. Now, back to the noodle employee. He's a member of this. Watch what he said recently in Wisconsin.
There are two fundamental classes that are just a plain fact in society. You either work for someone else or you work for yourself. And most people work for someone else in a way that they aren't free. You don't really get to decide your work. For example, I work at Noodles, a restaurant. And basically, it's a dictatorship there. We're told exactly what we're going to cook, how we're going to cook it, what time we're going to get there. And basically, if they don't like what they're doing, they try to tell us what to do. If we don't listen, they get rid of us.
The nerve. Noodles makes them cook noodles. How they want the noodles cooked. And he has to show up on time. This dope wasn't there when Kennedy made noodles a different way and he was losing money. If this kid thinks Noodle is a dictatorship, he should try living in Iran for a while. What's wrong with his noodle? His solution? Listen to this one.
I try to convince my fellow employees that we should have a union at Noodles, so it's a source of power to start with. And then I think in terms of the bigger picture, when you look at revolutions, the way that you actually get rid of any sort of dictatorship is by having workers take control of the place where they work.
Yeah. A noodle union, and everybody is celebrating the youth that are rioting and are causing riots. That's the youth that's doing it. He couldn't possibly try to work his way up the ladder and maybe become a franchise owner. No, no, no. Or maybe gather his friends together and do what his boss did. No, the only way is to unionize. But if they could overthrow Noodles, what would that mean for the current owner of Noodles that took all the risk?
If the owner wanted to cooperate with us as an equal and provide his skills that he had, we would definitely cooperate with him. He'd have to abdicate his position as being an owner and controller of us, and he would have to recognize that we run Noodles together, and basically, if he doesn't want to cooperate with us, he's against us. Mm.
This is the mentality we're fighting. Aaron Kennedy risked everything he had, his friendships, his own money. And now he's viewed as an oppressor by this dope. If there is a God, he'll find himself in the unemployment line.